in this video, you're going to learn how to format a paper for an MLA formatted paper using Microsoft Word. There are a few things that you need to do in order to make sure that your paper has all the proper settings so that it meets all of the requirements of MLA format. In Microsoft Word, you're able to do this fairly easily, and I'm just going to show you how to go through the settings and get everything the way you want it to be. So when you open up a new blank Microsoft Word document, it's going to look something like this. The first thing that you want to do is probably to adjust your font, because Microsoft Word sets a default font that is not what is required for MLA format. So if you go up to the top and click on the word home, if it is not already selected, you will see a toolbar that looks like this. Right here, you are able to change your font style and font size. So whatever it is set to by default, you want to change it to Times New Roman, size 12. Usually Word sets it to Calibri font size 11. So once that's done, the body of your paper will be in Times New Roman font size 12. You also want to make sure that your margins are set correctly, because in MLA style, you're required to have a 1-inch margin on all sides. Go up to the top toolbar and click on Layout, and then you will find a margins button on the left. If you click this, you will see options for your margin settings. By default, it will be set to 1 inch all around, but if for any reason you see any of these other options are set, be sure to select normal so that your margins will be 1 inch all around. You also want to adjust your spacing, because you need to have double spaced lines throughout the paper. So go back and click on home for that, and then click on the icon right here in the middle. If you hover over it, it will say line and paragraph spacing. Click this and select 2.0. That will set your spacing to double spaced. Also go in and click on the button that says remove space after paragraph. That will make sure that you do not have an extra space after each paragraph of your paper that will cause the spacing to be wrong. Once that's done, you want to write your header. And that is something that appears on the top of every paper that includes your last name and the page number. So the first thing you want to do is double click near the top of the page above where your default blinking cursor is. When you do that, it will take you to a mode that allows you to edit the header, so all your options up here should change. The first thing you should do is put in your page number. And so to do that, go over here to the left side of the top toolbar and click where it says page number. Put your mouse cursor over top of page and it should load a set of options, and you want to choose plain number 3, because that is what is going to put the page number on the right side of the page, which is what you want. The other thing you want in your header is your last name on every page, so you want to go on and type your last name, mine being Anderson, and then go and click on home, because this font needs to match the font of the rest of the paper. So you need to highlight everything and then reset your font to Times New Roman size 12, just like you did for the paper. Now your header is done. If you double click back into the body of the paper, it will turn gray, and that just means that it's set and it's not going to change. So if you finish typing on this page and it automatically rolls over to a new page, that is going to have your last name and then 2. So it's going to automatically fill in those page numbers for you. The next thing that you'll want to do is to add the header for your paper itself, and that's the area where you put your name, your instructor's name, and the name of the class and the date. So to place that heading, you're going to start by typing your first and last name. That is mine. You're going to put your instructor's name preceded by any title that they have. So for example, I would put Dr. Mary Smith. You will put the name of the class giving its number. So if you are in English 1100, you will put English 1100. So you would put Psychology 1100, Biology 1100, whatever class you're in there. And then you want to put the due date of the paper. So don't put the day that you're working on it, but put the actual date that the paper is going to be turned in. And in MLA format, you will put the number of the day before the month. So you will put in 2 April or 5 January or what have you in the year. That is your heading. And at this point, you are ready to write the paper. The thing that you want to do next is to type in your title, and you want that to be centered in the middle of the page. So up here on the top, you will go to the section here where it says paragraph, and you will see these lines, and this indicates how your writing is centered. So click on the second icon from the left that says center when you hover over it, and that will make sure that your writing is centered for the title. So here, you're going to type whatever you have decided to title the paper. Press enter to go to the next line, and then return and click on the align left button that will return your alignment to the left margin for the actual body of your paper. You'll push the tab key for your first paragraph, and then you will begin writing. At this point, you're ready to write your paper. Everything's formatted as it needs to be. And as you continue, when you reach the next page, it will automatically start a new page with the number 2 as your page number. The other important thing that you need to know is how to set up your Works Cited page. Your Works Cited page will need to have a centered title just like the main body of your paper. So again, you're going to click on the center icon up here, and you will type in Works Cited, capitalized like that. Enter down to the next line and click back on the left align. The next thing you'll want to do is to add your citations. You can often copy a citation from a database or create it yourself. The library has a lot of resources on creating MLA-style Works Cited entries if you need to do that. If I have copied my citation, I want to paste it here by right-clicking and then going down under Paste Options and selecting the middle icon that reads Merge Formatting. This will make sure that things like italics are preserved. When you paste it, it will be double-spaced as the rest of the paper is, which it should be, but you're also going to need to create what's known as a hanging indent that will indent the second line of your citation. In order to do that, simply click in front of the second line so that your cursor appears there before any text on that line, and then go up to the top toolbar. You'll see the word paragraph fairly small under this section where you've been accessing the alignment and the spacing options. There will be an arrow in the corner, and if you click on this, it will open up paragraph settings. When you click on this, all you need to do is go down to the second section of options under indentation, and where it says special, there will be a drop-down menu from which you can select hanging. So select hanging under indentation and then click OK, and it will automatically indent the second line of your citation. You may need to repeat this when you paste further citations depending on how those citations that you're pasting are formatted. At this point, you have your paper set up as it needs to be to meet all of the requirements of MLA formatting.